Hi friends, can hand gestures really improve the quality of your presentation? Well, in this video, I'm gonna give you ideas and thoughts on how to incorporate hand gestures into your presentation. That's coming up next. Hi, this is Dale from iTalkDEO, helping you to communicate better. Let's start off by talking about hand gestures, and I'm going to start with a simple example. In a presentation, I talked about a 10-year-old boy who was a fishing expert. He had brown hair, big round glasses, white shirt, shorts, and he wore Crocs. Now, this fishing expert, Charlie, was teaching the boys on the dock how to fish, and he pulled out his pole and dropped down the line, and in a blink of an eye, there was a little tug on the line. He gives a jerk, and he reels it up, and there, at the end, it's one of these small, exotic little fish. Charlie didn't think about it. He pulled out his knife, cut the fish's head off, gut it, and looked at the boys and said, "It's the butt that rock bass like." Well, in this example, you notice that I was doing a lot of hand gestures. Some people may call it miming, but in the process, what I'm doing is actually communicating my thoughts to the audience. And there are many techniques. And let's start off with the first theory about gestures and where gestures should actually appear in the body. Now, as a balloon entertainer, I can relate to this. Due to the fact that when I twist a balloon, I twist approximately from shoulder to waist. This is my working zone when I twist a balloon. That's typically because I'm entertaining to a group of people that are standing right around me. That is true when we are using hand gestures. We use and talk to people within a couple distance. Now, as my audience grows, my hand gestures become larger. And I'm now extending this imaginary zone, which is from shoulders to waist. And I make my gestures larger. And this is true when I'm speaking, because as I speak, if I'm talking to a large crowd, my simple bullet points of 1, 2, 3 may turn into something that is more like 1, 2, 3 to get to the larger crowd. And a lot of the videos that I've saw, they don't talk about this. So keep that in mind when we're doing our hand gestures. Now, there's a lot of different techniques, from showing things small to large to extremely large. We can talk about heights. We can talk about inclines. We can talk about a person going from one area to another area. Hand gestures is a form of communication. Now, I have two tips for you on hand gestures. First of all, write your speech. That is the key thing, is you need to know what you're going to talk about. And secondly, is look at your speech. When you look at your speech and you figure out what you've written down, you could see the points where, maybe if I'm talking about something over here, I can reference this side. And when I talk about another group, I could talk about them here. I could incorporate the two groups together and actually use this hand gesture or bringing your hands together. If the topic goes from this side to that side, I could use different gestures. Now, there is an unlimited amount of hand gestures you could use. I wish I could show you all of them, but it's impossible to show every hand gesture because your thoughts may be different than my thoughts. And that's some of the gestures that people talk about. Especially online, there's a lot of talk about palms up, palms down, talking with your thumb, or pointing. Again, it depends on what you're trying to stress in your message. If you are talking about somebody or something and you need to point right at that person to make a point, then go ahead and point. If you are talking to a general area, you may find that your palms are out. This again may tell the audience to ward off, or if you're cutting through things, let's get to the point. So again, hand gestures, it's a form of communication. Like talking, there are slangs and different interpretations for words. Hand gestures are the same thing. So if you're going to talk to an international crowd, I would ask, does these gestures that I'm doing have a meaning in your culture? Just to be on the safe side. And if they do, find out what hand gestures they use in their culture. So those are the tips about hand gestures today. I've hoped you enjoyed them. My name is Dale from iTalkDEO. If you like what you see, consider becoming part of the tribe and subscribe. Until next time, go watch a video.